Well, as we sit here and watch the Spurs try to win another title, yeah, it's hard not to think about the title you won and then walked off the court. I mean, this is supposedly the athlete's ultimate dream, right? Yeah, to walk away and retire a champion. We hear that a lot. Does it actually make it easier?
It's amazing. It's a great experience. And especially since you work through your whole career, you're trying to build up to that one great moment. It is kind of the ultimate achievement, and it's a nice way to walk out.
A lot of athletes have trouble retiring.
Yeah, the first year or two after you retire, it's real difficult because there's no place that you can get that same kind of energy level. There's nothing in your life that gives you that type of instant feedback. You got a job, but everything moves slowly. So there's a lot of excitement that you miss and a lot of intensity.
This is what transforming education looks like.
This next phase of your life has been largely about the kids that you work with through the schools that you've started.
Yeah.
You've put more than $10 million into schools. You've got four or five schools going now on your way to 20.
When I was back in D.C. at Naval Academy, we used to go to all the schools in the D.C. and Maryland area with the Police Athletic League and talk to them and say no to drugs and all that stuff. But a lot of those kids were in situations where, you know, drugs was the only way they saw out of their neighborhood. And well, say yes to what? You know, you're not giving them a great option. And so when I came back, I said, well, let's start right now, giving these kids a better option. And it's been fairly successful.
So who's your favorite Spur player? Oh, Tony Parker. Why do you like him? Because he's fast and he's handsome.
You do still get to be a part of the league. You're a minority owner in
right.
the Spurs.
Yeah,
and it's an interesting time to be an owner
right now, really, in the
NBA.
It's been very interesting, both good and bad.
What did you think when the Donald Sterling recording surfaced and that exploded?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I thought it was obviously a huge negative for the league. I thought Adam Silver did a great job responding very quickly, kind of getting ahead of all of the speculation and all the foolishness that surrounds that. But the league has to protect its reputation. They do it with players, they have to do it with owners too. And as an owner, I'm 100% fine with that. I think we need to understand that the things we do reflect on this NBA.
And you've been very outspoken against bigotry, not just racism, but homophobia. This is a very key time for that in sports right now.
Yeah.
We had Jason Collins be the first gay player, openly gay player in the NBA, Michael Sam,
right,
who's coming into the NFL. What do you think about the way the environment and things have changed since you were playing?
I truly don't think that it matters to most players. You know, when you're out there, you're not thinking about, you know, what this guy's sexual orientation is. Nobody really cares. You know, are we getting this job done? Can I trust you? Those are the bottom line questions that you ask your teammates. And if those answers are yes, then you know, shoot, it doesn't matter, you know, what their preference is. I think if your heart is right, you know, you handle things with the appropriate response. Right now, we're just so sensitive to everything. I think politics has made us that way. You know, you can't even talk politics. You go places now. People, you know, we have trouble having intelligent discussions now because people, you know, get overly upset about different things. But if you disagree, it's fine to disagree. Mm-hmm. Just disagree and respect one another and move on.
Are you amazed at the state of politics right now? Is it something you spent a lot of time thinking about?
Well, yeah, I think I spent a lot of time thinking about it because, you know, our nation puts so much in our politicians' hands to solve our problems, and if our politicians are crippled or non-functional, then we're not going to make a lot of headway, and that's kind of what's happening.
A verdict from the American people, and it can be summed up into three words: worst Congress ever.
We've got this national debt, we've got this, you know, all these different issues socially, and we've got a political system that's struggling to even make decisions, to get things done.
Well, you've already served your country once in the Navy. Why don't you run for office?
Well, I mean, people have said that to me, but I really don't have that interest, especially at this point. I've got kids in high school. I love being home. I love being a dad and a husband, and that's what I'm going to do until they don't want me around anymore.